Ladies and gentlemen, allow me now to invite to the podium Dr. Balaram Thapa, coordinator of the Climate Change Network Nepal.
Chair of this inaugural session and Secretary of the Ministry of Science, Technology and Environment, Dr. Kathmandu. Chair of this LDC group, UNFSCC, and the Joint Secretary of the Ministry of Science, Technology and Environment, Dr. Kathmandu. Honorable Chair of Adaptation from both. Sunimul Hub, the Senior Fellow IIED and Director of the International Center for Climate Change and Development, Atik Rahman, Director of the Center for Advanced Studies, Sam Peters, CEO, Climate Change and Development Knowledge Network, distinguished guests, participants, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, on behalf of the Conference Organizing Committee, let me extend a warm welcome to all of you in Nepal and to the 8th Annual Conference on Community-Based Adaptation. I know several of you arrived in the country a couple of days ago and have had the opportunity to see the grassroots community adaptation work in the field. I hope you enjoy the field trip, and I also hope that you will be able to make the most out of this conference through the process of collective sharing, learning and influencing over the next few days and beyond. The selection of Nepal as the venue for 8th annual CBA conference is strategic, especially at a time where the government of Nepal has made the policy decision to allocate 80% of global funds received for adaptations to be made available at the local village development committee level, which is the smallest political and administrative unit in the country. The development of Global Adaptation Plan of Action, in short, LAPA framework, further reinforced the government of Nepal's commitment to combat climate change challenges, particularly adaptation, as adaptation is most likely to leave the majority of people out of poverty. This pioneering LAPA framework aims to enable communities to draw from their local knowledge to engage in local adaptation work. The LAPA process intends to be bottom-up, flexible and responsive. While this initiative is very encouraging, it must be supported, expanded and nurtured by all stakeholders. But if you look at the flip side, the benefit of such policies and plans are far from being realized by the large majority of people, especially those who are most at risk. It is true, the progress on adaptation work has been incremental, but the pace is much slower than anticipated. The theme of this conference is financing local adaptation, and I would urge the conference participants to look at adaptation financing both from global and local perspective. That is, global financing for local adaptation and local financing for local adaptation. The participants who managed to go on the field trip last week would know the tremendous amount of time and effort invested by the local communities at the grassroots level on adaptation work with a variety of local initiatives and innovations. These are people who have contributed least to the problem, and their effort alone is not enough to produce impact at scale. They must be supported by the national government and international community in the endeavor. The theme of this conference comes at an opportune time as climate finance is one of the most hotly debated topics in climate change negotiations. While progress has been made in securing places for climate finance to assist developing countries with both mitigation and adaptation, however, the disbursed amount continues to be dismal. Clearly, more work is needed both by the national government and international community to shape the adaptation of financing regime, be it global or local financing, as well as to ensure that climate finance reaches the poor and places where it is being imposed. Today in this conference, we have over 450 participants representing 62 nationalities across the world. We also have a number of high-profile dignitaries this week with us. I hope you'll be able to take the full advantage provided by this conference to update and exchange information about the latest thinking and development taking place with regards to CBA financing planning and good practices around the world. Let me conclude by saying that there may be several context-specific pathways for climate-resilient development. However, a strengthening of institutions, pursuing a strategy of adaptive management, investing and bringing research in policy discourse or policy interface, expanding knowledge, sharing, mainstreaming adaptation in global development planning processes, integrating adaptation and disaster risk reduction, and more importantly, innovative mechanism to improve adaptation financing going forward and making it more accessible is critical, which can provide a viable option for building a climate resilient pathway. Thank you, and once again, and very warm welcome to all of you.